All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and today we are going to be talking about the latest update from boot mode, which if you guys are like me, you might have been a little bit confused because from like the title says, the Gen 2 B58s now have custom ROM capability. However, I don't know if I'm the only one that's been keeping up with this, but they announced this almost a year and a half ago. Back in October of 2021, they announced the release of the Gen 2 B58 custom ROM. And a couple months later, they released it for the Gen 1 B58. So at that point, I thought all B58s were covered. But I kept getting questions about when support was coming, and now I actually understand what the change is. So I think that probably sparked a lot of confusion with people that are asking me to make this video. So I'll try to explain everything that I know, so hopefully that you guys can understand if this applies to you, what you need to do to take advantage of this, and if it's something that's even useful for your specific goals. So hopefully you find this video useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. So we've talked about this in the past, but there are three different buckets of tunable Gen 2 B58s. The first bucket is from cars that were built before the June 2020 cutoff. If your DME was manufactured before June of 2020 or around there, you are able to unlock your car via a regular bench unlock. So you can go to a local tuning shop or send it out to somebody local to you so that they can hook it up to a computer, unlock it, and then send it back to you. At that point, you have all the capabilities of all the older Gen 1 B58s by doing OBD flashing. If you have a post-June 2020 manufacture date, then you have two options. You can either get a FEM2 unlock or a FEM2 clone. The FEM2 unlock takes your car's DME and unlocks it and sends it back to you. So very similar to a bench unlock, except there's only one company that can actually do the unlock currently. If you do a FEM2 clone, then you basically take a car from before the June 2020 cutoff and use that DME and clone all your car's information to it. So when you plug it back in, your car won't know the difference, but you have all the capabilities of a car before the June 2020 cutoff. Now, the cloning process is much more expensive. Finding a DME can be hard, and buying the DME is usually expensive, but the benefit is that those pre-June 2020 cars have a lot more capability, including this custom ROM feature. So that's who this feature was actually released for initially, and unless you had a clone, you were not able to use it. Now the reason why is because all of these custom features like flex fuel and anti-lag and map switching are coded to a section of the DME that is not unlocked by FEM2. That section of the DME has a lot of sensitive information, and FEM2 doesn't want to leave it unlocked because it could potentially release the way that they are unlocking the DMEs, which is obviously proprietary to them and a big part of their business. On the other hand, tuning companies don't necessarily want to share what they're modifying in those tables and in those sections of the DME with FEM2 because it's sensitive to them. They did all the R&D to develop the code, and so they don't want it shared publicly. So up until this point, majority of tuners were basically locking it down to only full unlocked DMEs or clone DMEs where you could flash that directly from your OBD port. But now what we're seeing is more companies are working with FEM2 to provide the information that they need so they can flash that custom code to your car and enable those, enhanced capabilities. So that's basically the bottleneck that we're facing right now. Obviously the tuning industry is extremely competitive and everybody is very sensitive about their private information. It's also kind of funny because we're only in this mess because BMW introduced this new encryption and they don't want us modifying our cars and all this stuff, when in reality, they are in the exact same boat. They want to protect their private information that's in the DME, so they lock everything down so other OEMs can't, copy their tuning methods and stuff like that. So just like BMW wants to protect their property that's built into the DME tuning, these aftermarket companies want to protect their intellectual property as well. But all of that aside, FEM2 and Boot Mode are now working together to provide this as an option for BM3 customers. So what does that mean? Well, all Gen 2 B48 and B58 vehicles will be able to use custom ROM. if you have a Femme 2 unlock or a more expensive Femme 2 clone, or of course, the cars before the cutoff. Now, if you already have a Femme 2 unlock, you are going to have to send your DME back in order to get this added to your vehicle. So hopefully you guys are in a position where you can take advantage of it. I know it sucks if you have to send your DME twice, but if you want all of these features, then that's what you're going to have to do. Now, it does enable map switching, which allows you to run up to 4 different map slots, and you can switch maps for different fuels, burble settings, a bunch of different features right on the fly. It also enables anti-lag, so you can basically quick spool your turbo for roll racing, and then when you release it, it'll give you full power right off the hit. And flex fuel, which is basically the biggest one, the main thing that I was looking for before all of these were released. If you're going to be using ethanol, then the flex fuel capability allows the car to automatically adjust for any amount of ethanol content. So all you have to do is fill up at the pump and drive. It also does give you the capability to read your ethanol content on the fly. So you can use the steering wheel buttons and it will basically turn your tachometer into an ethanol gauge and tell you up to, E75, what your actual ethanol content is. So this is really big news. Obviously the Femme 2 unlock is a lot cheaper, and that's why most people go that route, especially if they're just running off the shelf maps and stuff like that. So being able to have this as an option is really cool. The only thing to keep in mind is that they are still working on implementing all of the software versions for the different cars. So they've updated their wiki page to include all of the ROM IDs that are currently supported, including the mild hybrid cars. They're working on adding those. So you'll want to basically check your software ID against the list that they have on their wiki to make sure that it's available for you before you send your DME out. Also, they've had a couple other updates, including flex fuel kits that have officially been released for the Gen 2 B58, and they have options to mount it on the fuel hat, on your low pressure fuel pump, or in the engine bay, like some of the more recently released flex fuel kits. So that's a really nice option to have. It's easier to install than removing your seats and all of that, and easier to access with everything in the engine bay. So hopefully they release that as an option for F-Series as well. And then one last update that I think is really nice to have is the ability to see shadow codes as well as code history. So in the past, when you scanned your car with boot mode, it would only show active codes. And it was kind of frustrating if you cleared codes on your car or if the issue went away, you weren't able to see what happened. So now you can actually see shadow codes that will indicate if something previously happened, but it's not happening anymore. It'll still store that data so that you can see what the code was thrown for. And it'll have code history, so you can scroll back and see scans from past dates to see what issues you've had, days or weeks in the past. So, yeah, it's definitely been a long time coming for that one. That was an ask from a lot of people, and I'm happy to see that they're finally adding it to the app. But yeah, overall, again, this is a huge update for those of you that are running a Gen 2 B58 and just want the tuning process to be as easy as possible. Again, keep in mind this locks you in. All of this needs to be specified before you send your DME out. But if you do that, you'll get it back with all of the enhanced and extra features and capabilities available to you so that you can go on and continue with your build. So yeah, I think that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.